Our Prophet, may God bless him and grant him peace, was just, affectionate, compassionate, and peace-loving, and he had a reconciliatory nature. He was a messenger who placed his trust in God and had a moderate, patient, courageous, modest, and determined character. Such moral virtues are a role model for everyone. In a verse from the Quran, God reveals, "You have an excellent model in the Messenger of God, and for all who put their hope in God and the Last Day, and remember God much." The moral virtues of the Prophet are described in detail in the verses of the Quran. In addition, statements narrated from his companions also provide considerable information about our Prophet. Many details, such as his relations with his family and the believers around him, details of his daily life, his physical appearance, the feelings of awe he inspired in those who saw him, the food he enjoyed, his clothes and smile are all described by Islamic scholars with the term shamail. The term, plural form of the word shimal, comprises such meanings as character, nature, mood, action, behavior, and attitude. Even if the concept of shamail originally had a broader meaning, it became more specific over time and eventually became a term used to describe the details of the life of the Prophet and his personality traits. The companions of the Prophet have passed on a great many details about him, from the beauty of that blessed individual's physical appearance, his radiance and disposition that left those who beheld him in awe, to his smile, and many other beautiful aspects that God had manifested in him. There were a fair number of such companions, and they have given many details of his great beauty to those Muslims who did not live at the same time as the Prophet. While some of those describe him in broad terms, others have given long and detailed descriptions. Every detail of the character and appearance of this chosen servant of God is at the same time a reflection of his superior morality. The main intention for the composition of this film on the physical appearance of the Prophet is to examine those of his features that have been described in sources that have come down to us, and for us to draw inspiration from them for our own lives. As we can discern from those who saw him in person, the Prophet was extraordinarily handsome, with a finely proportioned body and a face that took one's breath away. He also had a very athletic and powerful build. The companions described our Prophet's physical beauty thus: "The Messenger of God was very handsome and attractive. His holy face shone like the full moon on the 14th of the month. His nose was very handsome. He had a thick beard, large eyes, and flat cheeks. His mouth was wide, and his teeth as bright as pearls. His neck was like a silver beam. The space between his shoulders was broad, and the ends of his shoulder bones were thick." Caliph Ali's grandson, Ibrahim ibn Muhammad, narrates, "In speaking of our Prophet, my grandfather, Ali sets out his qualities thus: he was neither very tall nor excessively short, but was a man of medium size. He had neither very curly nor flowing hair, but a mixture of both. He was reddish white, and had wide black eyes and long eyelashes. He had protruding joints and shoulder blades. He had a finer chest than anyone else, was truer in utterance than anyone else, had the gentlest nature and the noblest lineage. Those who saw him stood suddenly in awe of him, and those who shared his acquaintance loved him. Those who described him said they had never seen anyone like him before or since." God chose the Prophet Muhammad over all the worlds and revealed in the Quran that he is the last of the prophets. Muhammad is not the father of any of your men, but the messenger of God and the final seal of the prophets. God has knowledge of all things. No prophet would be sent after the Prophet Muhammad, and the Quran would be the last revelation to guide people onto the true way. God manifested that unique feature of the Prophet with a mark on his body. In Islamic sources and oral accounts, that mark between the Prophet's shoulder blades is known as the seal of prophethood. It is reported by Wahb ibn Munabi that the other prophets also had similar marks, but that that of the Prophet was different.
El-Müstedrek tarafından Behib bin Münebbih radıyallahu anh'dan şöyle nakledilmiştir.
God never sent down a prophet who did not have the sign of prophethood on his right hand. The Prophet Muhammad was the only exception to this. His sign of prophethood was not on his right hand, but between his shoulder blades. When asked about it, the Prophet said, "This mark between my shoulder blades is like the marks on the prophets before me." Blessed Ali's grandson, Ibrahim ibn Muhammad, narrates, "In describing the qualities of our prophet, my grandfather Ali would reiterate the whole length of the hadith on the description of his appearance and say, the seal of prophethood was situated between his shoulders. He was the last of all prophets." Abu Nahtra says, "I asked Abu Sa'id Khudari about the seal of prophethood of the Messenger of God. He said it was a piece of raised flesh that was on his back." There are different descriptions of the length of the Prophet's hair. It is natural that there should be discrepancies between them, as the people these accounts have come down from saw him at different times, when his hair may have been of different lengths. Yet what can be recognized from these descriptions is that the Prophet's hair was at ear level at its shortest and at shoulder length at its longest. Anas bin Malik reports, "The hair of the Messenger of God reached till half of his ears." Our mother Aisha narrates, "The Prophet's holy hair was between his ears and his shoulders. May God bless him and grant him peace." Bara bin Azib says, "The Prophet was of average height, and the portion between the two shoulders was wide. His hair reached his earlobes." Hani, the daughter of Abu Talib, offers the following description. "The Messenger of God came to Mecca once after the Hegira. His blessed hair had four plaits."